revelations.
One of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw and beheld the pale horse, and his name that sat on him was Death, and Hell followed with him.
Oh,
in your laboratory, your experiments, dreaming up something new. You're a dreamer, Doc. Too much money is bad for dreamers.
You try to dream flattery, telling me that I'm a dreamer. Well, I do dream. Dreams that you could never guess.
Your nerves are made, Doc. Calm down. Get a grip on yourself. You've been working too hard on your formula.
That's the child's play for great science. Your brain is too feeble to conceive what I have accomplished. Freedom of science.
Doc, you've made some great scientific discovery. What is it?
Then you'll find out, Henry. It's too late.
Come, Doc. You can't pretend to control a man's destiny.
I've already proved it. 2 times.
as it reaches the public mind, has both served to discredit and unintentionally reaffirm mystical ideas. During the Age of the Enlightenment, certainly people who were interested in astrology, divination, alchemy, out of royal courts and mainstream universities, this light shone throughout Europe, and people were interested in Newtonian mechanics, never mind the fact that Newton himself also had a lifelong interest in alchemy. But the irony was that some people who were at the forefront of the Enlightenment were enamored of the religious experiments that occurred during the Renaissance. But regardless, their experiments and their rationalist philosophy removed occultism from perspective of courts and universities. That was nerd to make it really institutions.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.